okay, my friend Rachel Sklar is, okay, we're friends by online. We haven't actually met in person yet, but one day. It all started when I was doing some blogging with the Huffington Post, and she was editor over there, and who is now at Mediaite.com. Whatever. I want to cut to the chase real quick, because I have something I need to say. First of all, Rachel, I read, and I'm reading again your piece entitled Sexism in the City, another cringer from the New York Observer, and you're understandably upset that New York Observer writer, or blogger, whatever, Spencer Morgan, has written this kind of interesting piece that has an interesting title, Rowl, Beware Cougar's Young Niece, the Cheetah. What I think of it? Yeah, I thought it was offensive, yeah, but you know, I'm going to say something from an entirely different angle. First of all, I want to get this really quick off my chest because it's really not about him. It's about you. People who write stuff like that hate women, period. The other problem is that women are attracted to guys who hate women. I'm going to write another blog post about that, but the bottom line is I happen to know a lot of women who do not hate guys. They're not man haters. But there's a little pattern there. I'll get to that another time. Rachel, I want to tell you something, because next week is your 37th birthday. You're a gorgeous woman, okay? Very gorgeous. So don't listen to any commenter that, in fact, I don't read comments. Commenters online, about 40% of the time, a little loopy, you know? The 60%ers are okay, but those send emails, and I like that, okay? I like that. But the commenters, don't pay attention to them. The bottom line is this. Look at these photos. You are hot. And Rachel, you are hot. And if that's not enough, you're hot. Okay, if maybe sometimes you do that little kind of weird thing with the fingers and all that, and maybe one too many times, like in Minnesota was one with Julia Allison, whatever, but I'll let that go. The bottom line is you're this smart, gorgeous woman. Maybe one day, you know, it'll be your time. I don't know. I mean, I haven't had a chance yet to sit down over lunch or dinner or anything in New York and get together and just talk. Perhaps one day that'll happen. But the reason I'm saying this to you is to put this in your head. You've got to walk around and carry yourself like you are the hottest thing out there, because you are. If you don't think that, then you'll let all this other talk about cougars and cheetahs and pumas and all this crap get to you. Again, guys who think that way hate women. How many times am I going to say this? Guys who think that way hate women. That's all I've got to say. All right? Now, the other message I want to send to you is this. Maybe it's because you're in New York. Maybe New York's not the greatest place to find someone, just like San Francisco isn't. There's a lot of cultural change that's going on there that's positive and cool and terrific. But then, you know, sometimes I think of the people that I've met in San Francisco who are married and they're very happy, and I always counter myself on that. Another one. Also, maybe you're just looking for just a Jewish guy. Maybe that's you've got that focus there that's just narrow. Maybe it's time to broaden that focus a bit. Just a thought. I don't know. But my point is this. Coming back to my central theme here. You are a gorgeous woman. You've got to recognize it, be it, feel it, and do it, and ignore those people who don't see it. Happy birthday.